Well, praise God. Good morning. Welcome, family. Welcome to our broadcast this morning. Thank you so much for joining us wherever you are. So wonderful to have another opportunity to share the word of God, because the Bible says this is our daily bread, his very word that has been broken for us. So let us just get ready to receive the word of God this morning. Get your pen, get a notebook, get a Bible, and get a cup of coffee as we get ready to share the word of God this morning. Amen. Before we go to the word of God, I'd like us to open up in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning for another glorious and wonderful opportunity, Lord God, to share your precious word. We thank you, Lord, O God, that it's your word which gives us strength. It's your word which gives us, Lord God, encouragement. And it's your word, it's by your word alone that faith cometh, Father. So I pray this morning in Jesus' blessed name, Father God, as we, Lord, would share your precious word. I pray, Lord, that you'll touch each and every person, Father God, at their point of need. We thank you this morning, O God, that there is no limitations and no boundaries, Lord, to the Spirit of God, that, Lord, you are with us here and you are with those there, wherever they are, Father God. I thank you that there's a divine connection, and I thank you this morning that there's a divine exchange this morning in the lives of every individual, Father God. We thank you this morning for all, Lord God, that you have in store for us. We thank you in advance, O God, and we thank you, Father, for the gift of life that you've given unto us in Christ Jesus, your Son, our Lord and Savior. And we pray this morning that you'll bless the teaching and the reading of your word. I pray, Lord, that you'll breathe life into your word. And as that life, O Lord God, has been breathed into the word of God, I thank you this morning, Father, that there's life that will be imparted to every individual in Jesus' blessed name. May circumstances be changed. May difficulties and hardships, O Lord God, may they, Lord God, change, and let there be an anointing of ease that will come upon your people. I thank you that there'll be a power of endurance this morning, O God. In the name of Jesus, O Lord, we give you praise, glory, and honor in Jesus' blessed name. And God's people said, amen, amen, and amen. Well, praise God. This morning, I want to share something with you from the book of Romans, chapter number 5. And I want to pick up from verse number 1. The Bible says, therefore, having been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom also we have access by faith into this grace in which we stand. I want you to highlight that. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, we also have access by faith into this grace in which we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. It's the grace of God which causes us to stand in the midst of life's challenges, in the midst of our circumstances. It's the grace of God which causes us to stand and to rejoice in the hope of the glory of God. It doesn't matter what we're going through as believers in Christ Jesus. We are standing on the rock, and that rock is Christ Jesus. And as long as we are standing on the rock, we have this joy within us. We have this confidence within us that God is with us. We have this confidence within us that God will come through for us. We have this confidence within us that God will not fail us. Hallelujah. Praise God. He says, and rejoice in the hope of the glory of God. It means that whatever situation I'm going through, I'm standing in the grace of God, because it's the grace of God which saves. It's the grace of God which heals. It's the grace of God which delivers. It's a grace thing. It is not a work thing. There is nothing that you could do, nothing that I could do that could ever get us saved and that could ever get us healed, but it's purely the grace of God. The grace of God means it's the goodness of God. It means the divine influence of God, which he exerts upon our hearts. It means the unmerited favor of God. Hallelujah. It means unmerited favor. Just think of it. How many accounts in scripture we find that when an angel came and would speak to someone, would say, you have found favor with God. Wow. When you find favor with God, you found grace with God. It means God, you have God's attention. And it's unmerited. There's nothing that we can do to score it. It's purely unmerited. Hallelujah. We have access by faith into this grace in which we stand. And that is all done through our Lord Jesus Christ. Ephesians chapter 3 verse 12 says, in the Lord Jesus Christ, we have boldness. Watch this. We have boldness and access with confidence through faith in him. Through Jesus Christ, we have boldness and access with confidence. Hallelujah. That means you are bold enough to pray. You are bold enough to call on the name of God. You are bold enough to cry out unto the Lord. You don't look at yourself and say, oh no, but you know, I'm not worthy enough. I'm not deserving enough. Friend, it's the grace of God. We are not all worthy enough. It's the grace of God which qualifies us. Let me share something with you in the book of Hebrews chapter number 4 before I go on. Hebrews chapter 4. Let me start reading from verse 14. Seeing then that we have a great high priest who passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast our confession. Let us hold fast our confession. For we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses. Watch this. We do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but was in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly. Watch. Let us come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Hallelujah. You can come boldly. Your prayers can be bold. You're bold in your prayers because you know that when you pray, God will answer. When you pray, you know God will come through. When you call upon his name, you know that God will hear you. Hallelujah. You know that when you open your mouth, he knows that it's you speaking. So wherever you are this morning, that's my encouragement to you this morning. You have access by faith. Access by faith through our Lord Jesus Christ. And you're standing in the grace of God. Hallelujah. And you have access. The word access translated was rather the definition of the word access from the dictionary. It means an opportunity to approach or enter a place. Wow, praise God. Through Jesus Christ, we have a wonderful opportunity to enter the throne room of God. Through Jesus Christ, we have a wonderful opportunity to approach his throne. You know, when you look at accounts of people that would come into the royal palace, especially to approach the throne, you would find that there would be guards by the door. And if you were permitted to enter, the guards would announce your arrival to the king that's upon the throne. And they would open the door and then they'll announce your name, that so-and-so has arrived, and everybody is at attention, and this person goes to and approaches the throne. And so it is with you and I. When you pray, and you're praying through the name of Jesus, Jesus is the door to the throne. Hallelujah. When you pray and you use the name of Jesus, I'm reminded of the account in scripture. Jesus says to his disciples, he says, up to now you have asked nothing in my name, but ask that your joy may be full. That means you have boldness to use the name of Jesus. Those who call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. You'll not be put to shame. Hallelujah. So Jesus is the door. And when you use the name of Jesus, the door opens now. The door opens. And that door opens for you to boldly enter the throne room of God. That when you are praying, when God hears that it's you, his child, all of the angels, all of heaven comes at a standstill, because this is my child. This is my beloved. This is my beloved in whom I'm well pleased. Because when God sees you, he sees you through the blood of Jesus. He does not see you through your past. He does not see you through your infirmities or your weaknesses. We just read it in the scripture this morning. Hallelujah. He was able to identify with all our weaknesses. He doesn't see you through your weaknesses. He sees you through the blood of Jesus. And he says, this is my child, angels of God. This is my child. You can come before for his throne. You can receive mercy and you can obtain grace to help you in your time of need. Hallelujah. So the Bible says that we have access by faith into this grace in which we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. It means it doesn't matter what I'm going through. I can rejoice in it because I know that God will come through for me. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And verse number 3 says, and not only that, but we also glory in tribulations. Tribulations is hardships and it's suffering. It doesn't matter what you're going through. It doesn't matter how difficult or how uncomfortable things may seem. My advice and my word to you this morning is you should glory in tribulations. You should glory in hardships. Glory in these things. The book of James chapter number 1 and verse 2 says, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces endurance, produces perseverance, produces patience. Glory to God in the highest. It means that I glory in tribulation because I know that I'm standing on the rock. I'm founded on the rock of my salvation, and his name is Jesus. And as long as I'm on the rock, I'll not be moved. Hallelujah. I'll still be standing. I'll still be standing. And that's my word to you this morning. It doesn't matter what you're going through. You'll still be standing because of the grace of God. You'll still be standing because of the rock of ages. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. You are standing in tribulation and you can rejoice in tribulation because you know that you'll see the glory of God. You know that you'll see God come through. You know that you'll see God will show up in your life. Knowing that tribulation, watch this, knowing that tribulation produces perseverance. Perseverance means that I just shared with you now. It is patience. It is endurance. Hallelujah. Tribulation produces endurance. You come out stronger. You're able to endure more. And perseverance, endurance, produces character. And character is the ability, or rather the quality of being approved. You see that? Endurance will approve you. Endurance to say this person is deserving. I'm reminded of people that run marathons. Think of our local comrades marathon. You cannot run halfway. You cannot run a quarter of the way or three quarters of the way and say, I've run a comrades and I'd like a medal. No, you only get it when you finish that, when you cross the finish line. That is when you get the medal. That means that you endured it. You endured the downs. You endured the ups. You endured those bends. You endured it all. And you are deserving of it. Hallelujah. So character is the quality of being approved. So perseverance produces character. Perseverance gets you approved. And character hope. You see that? Character hope. Once your character is molded, now you have hope. Listen, brothers and sisters in Christ, as we endure hardships, as we are enduring hardship, as we endure hardship, it is God who works in us to develop certain qualities and virtues to strengthen us and to draw us closer unto himself. You see that? As we endure hardships, God is also at work. It means that it doesn't mean that God just sits and he just looks at you going through your hardship. No, as you are enduring, you know, I'm reminded of, you know, when we were growing up, we would have athletics, and you find that when the child is running, you find that very often, as I shared with you, how the parents would run with their children. And I can just see it now. You're running your race. It doesn't matter what you're going through, but you're running your race. And I can see the host of heaven cheering you on. The cloud of witnesses that surround us cheering you on. Come on, brother. You've come up. You've come too far to give up. Come on, sister. You can do it. You can make it. You can finish this race. You can endure this thing. Hallelujah. Your Father God, God is so concerned about your well-being. The Bible says he loves us more than our parents ever would love us. And I can just see it. If our own parents could run alongside of us while we were running our races. I remember some kids used to be right in the back. You find a kid right at the back. They last. And the parent would run along that child and say, come on, my child, you can do this, you can make this. All of a sudden, it's like the child gets turbocharged, like the adrenaline kicks in. And you find this child now from last, they start passing each person one by one. And I can just see that this morning. I can see you passing every challenge, every obstacle that is in your way. I can see you have run a good race. Keep on running by faith. Keep on running in the spirit. Hallelujah. The Bible says perseverance. Tribulation produces perseverance. Perseverance, character. And character, as I share, character is the quality of being approved. That means that you have done it. Hallelujah. You have an entitlement to this thing because of your character. And character, hope. Now, hope does not disappoint because the love of God has been poured out in our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given unto us. Oh, praise God. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit is the one who's constantly and continuously assuring us and reassuring us and encouraging us in the things of God. Hallelujah. Romans 8 and verse number 9 says this, but you are not in the flesh, but in the spirit, if indeed the spirit of God dwells in you. Now, if anyone does not have the spirit of Christ, he is not his. You have the spirit of God, the spirit of Christ. This is the life that you now live, the life in the spirit and not in the flesh. Hallelujah. Praise God. You're not living this life in the flesh. You're not living by what you can see, feel, touch, or hear. You're living purely in faith, by faith in the word of God. You're living in the spirit. That means it is possible. Look at Jesus. When Jesus lived his life, he didn't live his life in the flesh. When they were in the deserted place and they were faced there with the multitudes, and Jesus says to his disciples, he says, I have compassion upon the crowds, for they've been with us all day long. One of the disciples says, oh, send them away. Let them go home and let them go and buy something for them to eat. And Jesus looks at the disciples and he says, you feed them. Hallelujah. He says, you feed them. And one disciple says, but master, 200 denarii worth of food is not enough for these multitudes, for this crowd. But there was one disciple who came to Jesus and said, master, there's a young lad here with a few loaves and a few fish. What did Jesus do? Jesus took the loaves. He took the loaves. He took the fish. He looked up to heaven. He blessed it. He gave it to his disciples. And they distributed and everybody ate. And at the end of that sumptuous meal, they took up 12 baskets full. That's showing you, friend, that Jesus lived out of the provision of God. He lived out of the resources of heaven. And I believe that God will come through for you. Hallelujah. There's nothing that you can face in this life, nothing that you can go through within this life that God hasn't already provided it for you. He's already provided it. Hallelujah. He's the King of Kings. He's the Lord of Lords. And he's seated upon the throne this morning. In the midst of your circumstance, in the midst of your challenge, God is still God. The Bible says he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Before we leave this morning, I would just like to share a testimony with you that you received. And I want to encourage you, send us your prayer requests, send us your praise reports. We always love to hear you. And this is a word from somebody who shared their testimony with us just yesterday morning. She says, oh, wow, I sent a prayer request 2 weeks ago to ask for prayer for me to get my rent money. Not all came, but it was a great breakthrough for me after having received nothing for 3 months. Praise God. So sister, thank you for your prayer request. Thank you for your praise reports. We believe that God ain't done with you yet. God has got plenty more in store for you. Hallelujah. So you just rest in faith, rest in hope. God is going to come through. I believe that with all of my heart. That is what we believe. Amen. Praise God. Now, before we leave, let us just close in a word of prayer this morning. Praise God. Father, we thank you for, Lord, your goodness, your love. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you, Lord, oh God, for your hand which is stretched out towards us. Father, we thank you for your precious word. Thank you this morning, oh God, for your people this morning. I pray for everybody that has been under the influence, Lord, of this telecast. I pray that the grace of God will be with them. Father, we pray for our professional people. We pray for our business people. We pray for our students. We pray that your hand be upon them. Father, we pray for those, Lord God, who are unemployed. We pray that you will open doors of opportunity for them, Father, in the name of Jesus. Almighty God, we pray for those, Father God, who are sick, that they be healed. Oh yes, Lord, that they be made whole, made well, made complete in Jesus' blessed name. Father, we pray, Lord God, for our students, Father, who are going back to school this week. We pray your hand of protection over them. Father, we pray you cover our children. We plead the blood of Jesus upon our children. We plead the blood of Jesus upon our educators and upon our schools. We pray, Lord, that you keep them all under your love and care in Jesus' blessed name, Almighty God. Father, we pray for our leaders in government. Father, we pray you give them wisdom, give them understanding, and grant them great counsel, Father God. We pray, Father, for our medical, Lord God, fraternity. Father, the nurses and the doctors, Father, we pray you give them strength. We pray you protect them, protect their families, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We pray, Lord, you'll grant them wisdom, Father, and understanding, Father, that they'll know how to deal with what they are faced with this day, Father. And I thank you, Father, you're the God of the breakthrough. And I thank you, Father, that you will bring forth a medical breakthrough. I thank you, Father God, that you are the one, oh Lord God, who is still in control. You're still on the throne. So we rest in our hope in you, our confidence and our trust in you, in Jesus' blessed name. And God's people said, amen, amen, amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Bless you. Thank you for joining us. This is Pastor Ricardo saying thank you for joining us. God bless you. We love you. Until next time, goodbye and God bless.